Hi, I'm Zach Meacham, welcoming you to another edition of Boiler Bytes. Now, beer probably isn't the first thing that comes to mind when you think about farming, but there's a particular crop, crucial to the brewing process, that has recently increased in demand and piqued the interest of Indiana farmers. Hops is a plant that hasn't been grown consistently in the Midwest for over a century. However, researchers at Purdue are hoping to change that.
We have four main ingredients in beer. Water makes up the majority of the beer. Malted grains, hops, and then yeast.
Hops are a perennial plant. They can grow up to 20 feet tall on a trellis. They make cones, which are the flowers, the female flowers, and that is the part that goes into the beer.
Hops do a couple of things. One, they help preserve the life of the beer. It's a natural preservative. They also balance the sweetness from the malt sugars with bitterness from the hop compounds.
Predominantly, hops are grown in the Pacific Northwest. They used to be grown in the East and also in the Midwest a while ago, but then production just moved west and it stayed out there.
The production environment in the Pacific Northwest is really ideal for hops. They have very low humidity, so low pathogen pressure, and they've had irrigation from the dam system. So a lot of these specialty crops moved out west because of those environmental conditions. And so with the rise in the microbrewers, a lot of the microbrewers are having trouble sourcing hops from the Pacific Northwest because they're all grown under contract.
Breweries are getting ever more popular, and so certain varieties are hard to get a hold of. Peoples started in 2009. We set out to be a local production brewery, distributing beer around town to the different bars and restaurants, and also around the state of Indiana. Absolutely, we want Indiana hops. We'd love to see it grow into a sustainable industry, both for the growers and for the brewing industry. We'd love to see some varieties developed in Indiana that have unique characteristics that we can use basically as local characteristics in our beer.
There's a need for small batches of hops, and then there's a lot of interest in just local production systems and, you know, why ship your product in all the way from the Pacific Northwest when you can grow it here. And so we're really doing the research to try to adapt the production practices from the Pacific Northwest here to Indiana.
This summer, Purdue built a hop farm at the Meigs Research Farm. We put in a quarter of an acre to test different varieties to see how well they would grow out here.
Hops are a very labor-intensive crop and require lots of infrastructure. So they're a perennial crop. You put them in, you have to have a trellis system to support those, which the traditional trellis systems are 18 feet tall.
A lot of growers in the area have been using recycled telephone poles. Poles are then set into the ground about 4 feet. Aircraft cable is wired through the top as a support system, and then twine is strung from the top of that and anchored into the ground, and the hops grow up that each year.
The establishment costs and the labor to get that going are pretty intensive.
Your first couple years, you're not gonna make money off of it. It takes about 3 years for hops to really reach their yield potential.
Well, we're doing a lot of research just to adapt production practices, and then on the outreach side, we're doing a lot to try to work with the growers, get them together. And then we just do a lot of workshops at our research yard to teach people how to grow hops, where we'll talk just, you know, basic infrastructure, what you need to get started, what varieties might do best here.
There's potential for hops to be profitable in Indiana, but a lot of the growers are taking it slow just because to see what sort of yields and quality they can get since hops haven't been grown in the Midwest in a long time.
So for our first season, we decided to put in 1 acre. Coming spring, we're trying to put in another 2 acres, depending on us being able to get all of the supplies needed to construct that trellis system. Need to give credit to Purdue for the help that they have given. It's been a major learning curve. Nobody does it here in the Midwest, so there's not really anybody to lean on. Purdue's been, bar none, a huge help.
It's a difficult crop to grow. It's much more challenging than to grow like an annual crop like corn. So you really need to make sure you have the right mix of fertilization and water and varieties that are well suited to our system. Then you've got to pick the hops at the right time. You've got to process them in the right way to really preserve the quality. And then even from there into the brewing, that's a whole scientific process to it.
There is a lot of science to it, both on the growing side and on the brewing side. We look at alpha acids and beta acids and a lot of different compounds in the hops. Getting a good analysis, which is one of the things we're working with Purdue on, is important for knowing how to use them in the brewing process.
The future of hops in Indiana looks promising.
We're actually, I think, now to 1% of the hop acreage in the United States, which doesn't sound like a lot, but it really shocked the people in the Pacific Northwest.
Beer industry is growing a lot in the state. It's exciting to see it developing and be a part of it on the grassroots level.
This coming season, the team at Purdue plans to expand its hop acreage, test new varieties, and share its research findings with the farming community. That wraps up another Boiler Bytes. Be sure to check us out online at boilerbytes.com. We'll see you next time.